Energy. Welcome back to my channel. So excited that you are here. Thank you so much for clicking on the video. I appreciate you. It's Jody Dunn. I'm coming at you with my Sunday Walgreens haul and my Halloween costume. I'm dressing up as Rudolph for Halloween. Let me know if you dress up for Halloween. We do not. I mean, the kids do. But my husband and I have never dressed up for Halloween. If you follow me on my other channel, you already know where these came from. My other channel is linked below. And in my decluttering process, I could not bring myself to get rid of these, so I kept them. But I will tell you, they're kind of like, every time I breathe too heavy, it fucks my glasses up. So there you go. I'm going to be Rudolph for Halloween. If you are dressing up, I would love to hear what you are dressing up as. It sounds like such a fun idea to dress up as an adult, but I don't know. We've just never done it. If you are new to the channel and you just found me, I am so happy that you are here. Would you please say hello to me right down there? I would love to know that you are new, and I would love to welcome you and say hello back to you. And if you are already subscribed, thank you so much for coming back to another video. I appreciate you. Are you excited for Walgreens couponing this week? There were quite a few deals that I was excited about. And I decided to do a little newbie-friendly transaction in today's haul. So if you are newer to couponing at Walgreens, I'm going to show you a super simple transaction that you can do. All right, I do want to give you a quick update. I better take these off because we got a little bit serious talk. We got serious talk, and I don't know if I can be serious as Rudolph. Thank you so much to my friend, who I will not name, because she is actually a Walgreens employee and shared with me a memo. We all know the ad has changed and we're not getting sneak peeks. I don't know if that's going to continue happening where we don't get sneak peeks, but she basically sent me a memo letting me know what was happening. Now, some of you are so funny. And you're like, we're being punished because of early activation, or it's totally because of early activation. No, it is not. That has nothing to do with this change. Zero to do with this change. I know we like to try to figure out why things are happening. And so sometimes we'll put in reasons that really truly have nothing to do with it. This has nothing to do with early activation. Walgreens is making a change because Walgreens is a business. And businesses make change often. And us as the consumer, we don't like change. I hate the ad. I hate it. I know y'all do too. I don't know. Let me know if you actually like it. I don't like that we're not getting a sneak peek early. Hopefully that will change. But basically, the memo just stated that as of October 24th, that app users would see, or Walgreens users would see, a new and improved ad that catered more to their shopping needs. Now, I will tell you, as I've been playing with it a little bit, there are some nice features on the ad that were not there before. Like, you can clip the digital coupon right under when it shows you the deal. It will also show you if there's a digital coupon available. You can clip it right there versus going into your coupons. You can clip on the deal and it will actually show you the products that are included with that deal. But that's about the pros that I found so far. If you do not like the ad, submit feedback. You can go online and submit feedback. You can web chat. Maybe if enough people submit feedback that they don't like the new ad, that it's too confusing, maybe they will switch it back. Let your voice be heard. Doesn't mean that they're going to make that change, but they might. They have made changes in the past that the consumers did not care for, and they got so much feedback that they did change them back. So if you really don't like it, it is worth a shot. I have already submitted my feedback that I do not care for this new layout at all. Now, I am so grateful that my friend Sarah, Shop with Sarah, had told me about the Flip app. Because I've been using that, we can see the sneak peek on that, and I can figure out the deals that way. We always figure it out. We always figure it out. So don't stress about something like that. Even though Walgreens is not releasing the ad early, the Flip app shows us, so we can figure it out. All right, so we are going to head into Walgreens and do some awesome deals. I'm going to do a spend scenario that I am working with, and then I'm going to do a newbie-friendly transaction. And of course, we will debrief at the kitchen table. Happy, happy Halloween to you. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. I appreciate you so much. Let's run into Walgreens.
Happy Sunday and happy Halloween. We are in the Walgreens to do some deals. I received a digital spend booster of spend 50, earn back $10 in Walgreens cash that I cannot find in my clipped coupons. I searched all over. I don't know if Walgreens took it away or if it's just not showing up because of the weird changes. So I'm going to test it and see. Let me know if that's been happening to you. So the first deal I'm looking at is on the Always pads. They are on sale 2 for $10, and they are spend 10, earn back a $5 store coupon. I'm doing this particular deal because I have these two $3 digital coupons that are expiring today. Actually tomorrow, but I won't use them by then, so I want to use them up. So that's going to drop my total down to $4, and I will earn back a $5 store coupon, making these free plus a dollar money maker. And yes, the Always Z's is attaching when I add it to my cart, like I'm going to do a pickup order. It is coming off, so fingers crossed it comes off at the register. All right, next up, we're looking at Revlon because we still have Ibotta rebates. And it is on promotion this week for spend 15, earn back a $5 register reward. Now, we know the register rewards have been printing on the clearance items, but I don't believe the coupons are actually attaching to the clearance items. The coupons do say they exclude clearance. So I'm going to stay away from clearance, and I'm going to go ahead and get these cream eyeshadows that are priced at $8.49 each. So these two will total me $16.98. I have a 5 off 2 digital coupon that I'll use that'll drop me down to $11.98. I'll earn back a $5 register reward because I spent over $15, and I'll submit to Ibotta for $3 back each. So it makes my cost just $0.98 for these two, and that's before my spend booster is even factored in. Let me know if you try the clearance and your digital coupons actually apply, because I've been hearing that they are not applying. Now, just a reminder, if you look at these online, it does say that they are on promotion for spend 25, earn back $8 in Walgreens cash. That is an online promotion only. So if you were to do a curbside pickup for these, you will not get the online promotion. The online promotion is only valid for ship to store or ship to home. So some people get confused with that. If you do a curbside, you will earn the in-store promotion of spend 15, earn back a $5 register reward. All right, not a deal I'm going to be doing today, because although my area does receive the P&G coupons, they do not have the laundry product coupons in there, and we didn't get any digitals from Walgreens, which is a bummer. But the Tide, Bounty, and Charmin are on sale this week. Yes, the prices got raised to $5.49, and buy 4, earn back a $6 register reward. I will most definitely be doing this deal once I get my P&G coupons. All right, we've got different Febreze products on sale, 2 for $6. I'm going for the fabric spray, because even at Dollar General, these are $3.55 each. So this is a better deal. I love getting these at Walgreens when they are on sale, 2 for $6. So I'm actually going to go ahead and pick up 4 of these. And I do have a $3 digital coupon on the app off of 2. And then for the other 2, I'm going to use this $3 off 2 paper coupon. Well, it's a buy one, get one free, with a value up to $3. So that's gonna bring my price down to $1.50 each, and not even factoring in my spend booster. All right, next thing I wanted to grab was some Clorox disinfectant wipes. We have a Shopkick rebate on these, and I have an Only For You coupon. So check your accounts. This, when you scan this product, it does not come up, but I simply added it to my cart and it is coming off. So these are priced at $5.29. This is the big 75 count. I have a $1.50 off only for you coupon. That'll drop me down to $4.04. Then I'll submit to ShopKick for between scan kicks and purchase kicks, $1.36 back, making my cost $2.68 for this. All right, next up, I wanted to grab a package of the 3-pack of Kleenex, which are regularly priced for $5, but we do have a store IVC coupon for $1.25 off. So that'll drop that down to $3.75. And ShopKick has a rebate between scan kicks and purchase kicks for $1.86 back, which brings my cost down to just $1.89 for 3 packs of Kleenex, which I think is fantastic. I would have done the paper towel again like I did last week, but mine never reset. Let me know if yours reset for you. All right, I wanted to grab the Hershey's trees, which are on sale, and we have a digital coupon, but my store does not have them out yet. So I'm gonna pick up a little treat for myself because I love these Sour Punch straws. So they are regularly priced $4 for $4 or $1.69 each. So I'm gonna grab 4 of them because I need just a little bit more to get me to my spend requirement. So I have a total in product now of $52.02, but $1.25 is going to come off for the IVC, which is a store coupon and can never be counted towards any spend requirement. So that drops me down to $50.77. So I have hopefully my digital spend booster, which I am going to pair with this paper spend booster of spend $35, earn back $8 in Walgreens cash. And then I also have a register reward that's expiring today that I'm going to use to lower my out-of-pocket, and crossing my fingers, it won't kick off any of my digital coupons. Now remember, with those paper spend boosters, you cannot use Walgreens cash to pay unless you are doing the contactless payment method, which I do have a video linked in the description box of how to use Walgreens cash on any spend deal and still earn your Walgreens cash back. This particular account I'm using today, I do not have any payment method set up under contactless pay. So I'm just going to pay for this one using, of course, my PayPal debit card, which is just my rebate money. And then we're gonna go ahead and do a second transaction. I'm gonna do a newbie-friendly transaction. So we'll not be working with any spend boosters on this transaction, and my focus is going to be some very useful household products. So the first deal I'm looking at is the Angel Soft, the 9 = 18 rolls. They are on sale this week for $3.99 each, and they are buy 3, earn back a $3 register reward. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick up 3 packages of the Angel Soft. Truth be told, it's not my favorite toilet paper, but it's not horrible. So if you need toilet paper and you are a newbie starting off at Walgreens, this is a great deal to start with. Walgreens gave us a 50-cent digital coupon, and I also have a 50-cent digital coupon that I had clipped last week as well. So 3 of these total me $11.97. After my dollar in digital coupons comes off, that'll drop me down to $10.97, and I'll earn back a $3 register reward. So it makes my cost about $2.65 a pack. Now the 50-cent digital from last week is no longer available to clip, so if you didn't clip it, then your cost would be 50 cents higher. All right, the next deal I'm looking to pick up is on the Palmolive. This is on a month-long sale. It's on sale for $2.49 each, and buy 2, earn back $2 in Walgreens cash. So you can do this deal as many times as you want or any time throughout the month. And this is a buy deal where you buy 2, you earn back 2. So it doesn't matter if you use Walgreens cash. So these two total $4.98, and Walgreens did give us a 50-cent digital coupon. So that'll drop me down to $4.48, and I'll earn back $2 in Walgreens cash. So it makes my cost $1.24 each. All right, I'm pretty excited about this deal because we got a nice high value digital coupon. It's gonna be on the Nivea. They are part of the deal of the week, where if you spend $10, you earn back the $5 store coupon. So I'm gonna go for the women's Nivea body wash because we just do not get deals on this very often. And it's normally like $7 or something like that. So on sale for $5 each, I'm gonna go ahead and pick up 2 of these. And Walgreens gave us a $4 off of 1 digital coupon. So that'll drop these both down to $6, And then you would earn back a $5 store coupon, making your cost just 50 cents each. All right, per normal, we have some free oral care deals at Walgreens this week. One of them is going to be on the Colgate, the ones that are priced at $2.99 each. When you buy two, you earn back $3 in Walgreens cash. So two of these would total you $5.98. We do have a $3 off two digital coupon, which would drop you down to $2.98, and you would earn back $3 in Walgreens cash. So after Walgreens reward back, it would make them totally free. If you are a newer couponer and you do not have a stock of oral care, then definitely a great deal if you need to stock up on some toothpaste. The next really easy newbie-friendly deal is on the Crest, which are $3 each, and they are buy three, earn back a $4 register reward. So three of these would total you $9, and Walgreens did give us a $5 off three digital coupon, which would drop you down to $4, and you would earn back a $4 register reward, making them totally free. And there are some toothbrushes that are $3 as well that are included in on this deal if you'd rather have the toothbrushes. But if you're like me and you've been couponing, even maybe just for a little bit, oral care is something we can typically get free every single week. So unless it is making me money or making my deal make me money, I'm staying away from toothpaste. So instead, we're going to go with this newbie-friendly deal that I think is a great, great deal, which is going to be the three Angel Softs, the two Palm Olives, and the two Nivea Body Wash. Some really nice household essentials here. And as a newbie couponer, you're always looking, your goal should be to save about 50% if you can. So these nine products total me $26.95. After all the digital coupons, because this is a totally all digital deal, it'll drop me down to $21.45. Now, if you do have some Walgreens cash, you can use it to pay as much as you have because none of this is a spend deal. And we're going to earn back $2 in Walgreens cash for the Palmolive, a $5 store coupon for the Nivea Body Wash, and a $3 register reward for the Angel Soft. So we're earning back $10 in Walgreens store rewards, which drops our cost down to just $11.45 from $26.95. So we actually saved about 58%. As a newbie couponer, this is a really awesome deal, especially considering the awesome household products we got. Now, you can absolutely break your transactions up. Let's say you wanted to do the Nivea Body Wash in one transaction and then do your Angel Soft in a second transaction, enroll that $5 store coupon in your Angel Soft deal. You can definitely do that and get yourself a really low out-of-pocket. But I know a lot of times newbie couponers, or maybe you're not newer to couponing, but you're newer to couponing at Walgreens, and it can get a little tricky doing multiple transactions. You feel a little weird. You feel a little unsure. I know I did as a newer couponer. So I'm going to actually do this all in one transaction. But whatever you are comfortable with, you can do. Now, if you did happen to get a spend booster of spend 20, earn back $5 in Walgreens cash, I haven't seen that spend booster in at least a month. But if you did get it, and you wanted to do this whole transaction and pay cash out of pocket, you could actually get your cost down to just $6.45 for all of this. All right, let's head to the kitchen table and go over these receipts and our final cost.
All right, we are back at the kitchen table with my Sunday Walgreens haul. Let me know if you enjoyed the newbie transaction. I can continue doing that if that's something that brings some value. I don't do newbie deals very often. So let me know if that was helpful, if you liked that. All right, so let's go over my spend 50, earn back $10 in Walgreens cash transaction first. Let me know, I'm super curious if you do not see your spend booster. Now I do have a sneak peek spend booster
You know, the boosters that we get sometimes, well, actually I get them every single month of make 8 trips, spend $20, earn back $5 in Walgreens cash. Those amounts and trip requirements can vary per account. I see that one, but I do not see my spend 50, earn 10. And I did get a spend 50, earn 10 on another account as well. And I don't see that on the app either. So I was like, all right, let me just chance it and see if not, I'll contact customer service and see if they'll do anything. So I did have two little hiccups in this transaction. One was totally my fault. So I got the Febreze. I love grabbing those when they are on sale 2 for $6. And I love that we got the buy one, get one free. I grabbed the Revlon, my Sour Punch straws, the Kleenex, the Always, and the Clorox wipes. So let's take a look at my receipt. So there's all the Febreze ringing up at $3 each. There's my Always ringing up for $5 each. There's my two Revlon. You see modified here because the tag showed $8.49, but they ring up for $9.49. So thank goodness I had a cashier that I really liked today. And I was chatting with her and I said, wait a second, did those ring up at $9.49? Because the tag over there says $8.49. She said a lot of prices have increased, but they haven't changed the tags or they haven't gotten like the memo from corporate to change the tags yet. So she didn't even go look. She just price modified them for me at $8.49 because she knows me because I'm in there every week. So that was super nice. Definitely cheaper to do online if you're doing a curbside order, but you cannot use a paper spend booster when you're doing curbside. So I just did them in store. There's my Sour Punch straws at 4 for $4. There's my Clorox for $5.29. And there's my Kleenex for $5. Here's one of my hiccups that was my fault. I forgot to have the dank cashier scan the IVC book for $1.25 off. Because I was chatting with her and because of the Revlon ringing up wrong, I just totally forgot. And it ended up forming like this big line behind me of people. And I had a second transaction to do, which I just moved to the back of the line. That's what I do if there's anybody waiting for me. So bummer that I forgot to have them scan it. Customer service did already take care of it for me. I clipped it as a digital. I didn't even have it clipped because I was just going to have her scan the book and then totally forgot because I was chatting. So the only paper coupon I used was my Febreze buy one, get one free, which took off the $3. My Revlon digital came off. My Always came off. My Febreze digital came off and my Clorox came off. What did not come off was my second $3 Always. Probably my register reward attached to it. That's always a gamble you take when using register rewards, which is why I don't like using register rewards whenever I'm counting on digital coupons to come off, because they can attach to whatever product they want to attach to. And if they attach to one that you have a digital coupon for, then your digital won't come off. But when I did chat with customer service about my $1.25 IVC on that, they did credit me for the $3. Weirdly enough, I was like, oh no, what if it was the Always Z's that didn't come off? Because customer service may not credit me for that because it literally says Always Z's. That one is the one that attached. It was the other one. So they did credit me $4.50, which was awesome. So my subtotal ended up being $30.77. I was expecting it to be around $25, but that's not what happened. So what I earned back was $18.53. Hallelujah. So I did have the cashier scan that points booster of spend 35, earn 8. Even though I can't see my digital spend booster of spend 50, earn 10, I still did earn the Walgreens cash back. And then I also earned back my $5 store coupon, which was for the Always. And remember, the Always and the Nivea and quite a few other products are on that same deal. So you can only do it one per transaction because you will only get one register reward or store coupon per transaction. So my $5 store coupon for the Always printed, and then my $5 register reward, you can see it says manufacturer coupon up here, printed for the Revlon. And just to go over this again, there is a whole link in the description box where I have a whole video dedicated to register rewards and all things that print from the Catalina machine. So if you're not familiar, definitely check that out. But this literally shows up as a store discount because it is a store coupon, not a manufacturer coupon. You can only use one of these per transaction. It is one store discount per transaction. Of course, I could use my $1.25 IVC because that's product specific, but I can't use two or three of these in the same transaction. It will only take one. And again, this $5 amount will not count towards any spend requirement I may be working on, so I have to account for that. All right, so my cost for this transaction was the subtotal I paid plus my $7 register reward I used. So my cost was $37.77. I earned back $18.53 in Walgreens cash, plus $4.25 that customer service credited me. I earned back my $5 store coupon and my $5 register reward. Then I submitted to Shopkick for $3.22 back. I already got my kicks. That was super fast. And then I haven't yet, but I will submit to Ibotta. I might hold my receipt till tomorrow and see if I get a midweek for $6 back on the Revlon. So I earned a total of $42 and this cost $37.77. So it makes my transaction free plus a $4.23 moneymaker. And again, as I've explained in several videos, it is always easy at Walgreens to get a moneymaker if you're willing to have a subtotal. Normally what I would do, even with that paper spend booster, is I would build my transaction up. I would use contactless payment. I would use Walgreens cash to pay. I would get a much lower subtotal. But I didn't have contactless payment set up on this account, and I wanted to use this account today. So, all right, that was that transaction. And then I moved over to the newbie-friendly transaction. Again, I stayed away from oral care. I have no oral care in this transaction. I know a lot of us have just a huge stock of oral care. And like I said, in the store, if it is not making me money or making my deal make me money, I'm probably not going to get it, even if it gives me a lower cost. So I could have had a lower cost for this transaction. I just didn't want it. So I grabbed the 3 Angel Soft, the 2 Nivea Body Wash. I love this deal. I grabbed the 2 Palmolive. Now, the only other thing that I did grab was I did add 2 Snickers bars. Because in this transaction, I wanted to use another register reward that I had earned 2 weeks ago that was expiring today. And I wanted to have the lowest out-of-pocket I could by using Walgreens cash. I will tell you, if you are a newbie, what you would actually pay if you don't have Walgreens cash. But of course, I do. So I wanted to keep my cash out-of-pocket super duper low. So there are my 2 Snickers bars at 88 cents each. There's my 3 Angel Soft at $3.99. My 2 Palmolives at $2.49 each. And then my 2 Nivea at $5 each. So my digital coupon off the Nivea came off. My digital coupon off the Palmolive came off. And both of my digital coupons off the Angel Soft came off. And then I used that $4 register reward. So my subtotal was $19.21. With tax, it did take me over $20, so I just redeemed $20 in Walgreens cash to pay. As I have explained before, I don't like building up so much Walgreens cash on one account because your accounts can get locked. I know several people that has happened to you. So I started this transaction with $141, and I'm down to $123 now. I like to have around $180 to $100 on each account. So I still have $123, but I earned $2 in Walgreens cash for the 2 Palmolive. And then I earned my $3 register reward for the, it says Georgia Pacific, but that's for the Angel Soft. And then my $5 store coupon for the Nivea body wash. So as a newbie, if you didn't have any Walgreens cash at all to pay, and you did not get the Snickers bars, you just got the Palmolive, the Nivea, and the Angel Soft, your subtotal would be $21.41. If you don't have any Walgreens cash to pay or register rewards, then you would have to pay that cash out of pocket.
But after earning back our rewards, our cost drops down to $11.45, which makes it $1.63 each, which I think is a pretty fantastic deal, especially for a newer couponer at Walgreens. Now, like I said, in the store, you could do the Nivea if you wanted, and then you would earn back your $5 store coupon, and you could use that towards your Angel Soft to drop your cost, or you could use it towards your Palmolive if you wanted. So if you have Walgreens cash, definitely feel free to use it, unless you were working with a spend booster. Then at that point, you would only be able to use $5 in Walgreens cash to lower your out-of-pocket. All right, so that's what I got for you today. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. I appreciate you so much, and I'm going to see you again soon. Happy Halloween. Have a great day. Bye.